One common theme that you will find among most of the yarn-based parallel processing frameworks on Hadoop is the data parallel approach to problem solving. What is a data parallel approach, you may ask? Well, let me explain it to you using a very simple analogy. Suppose you were given a task of going through a stack of quarters and counting every single one of those that has an even number printed on it. So, for example, this one on the right with the year 1932 would count as one since 1932 is an even number. This is a pretty easy task to do with something like a swear jar, but suppose you were working at a bank with millions upon millions of coins to go through. Then the pile of quarters in front of you may look something like this. Big enough to make you depressed just thinking about all of the sleepless nights ahead of you. But then a thought crosses your mind. You remember all your friends who can help with this task and you invite them all over. Then what you do is you divide the original pile into smaller chunks. You give a chunk to every single one of your friends, and you ask them to perform the original task that was assigned to you, which is go through their pile of quarters and count the ones that have an even number printed on them. Then your friends started doing their work and reporting results back to you. So one of your friends may say, I've got 40. Another one could say, I've got only 2. And yet another one could say, I've got nothing. What you do then is you just add all of those numbers up and you arrive at the final answer, which actually happens to be an answer to the original task that was assigned to you. So this quarter counting is an example of a problem that has an excellent data parallel solution, or in other words, it has a solution that can get faster simply by you inviting more friends and giving them all work to do. In Hadoop's world, your friends would correspond to the parallel processing tasks managed by Yarn, and the pile of quarters would correspond to blocks in HDFS. Any problem that has a data parallel solution can thus be solved as fast as you want, provided that you add more workers to the pool. But still, there are limits. So let's talk about those. One obvious limit is based on how finely you can slice the data. After all, if you have 1 million coins and you invite 2 million friends, then at least 1 million of your friends would have nothing to do. A slightly less obvious limit has to do with the fact that even if you have more coins than friends, the total amount of time you spend on your task will be limited by how long it takes for your slowest friend to process his or her pile. So again, there is a problem. The final limit is actually the least obvious of them all. And it has to do with how much of your overall task can actually be parallelized. Because remember, we assume that the initial pile was a neatly stacked set of quarters, and you didn't have to do any upfront investment, like move them from one place to the other, or maybe sort them all out. If you have to do anything like that, and that part of your job cannot really be parallelized, then you are only benefiting from the part that can be, which is quarter counting itself. The practical effect of this last limit are so vast and so important that they actually have a special name in computer science. This limit is called Amdahl's law. It is named after computer scientist Gene Amdahl and is probably one of the most significant theoretical laws governing limits of every parallel processing system. Here's what Gene himself had to say about it. So let me quote. For over a decade, prophets have voiced the contention that the organization of a single computer has reached its limits, and that truly significant advances can only be made by interconnecting of multiple computers in such a manner as to permit cooperative solution. The nature of the overhead in parallelism appears to be sequential, though, so that it is unlikely to be amenable to parallel processing techniques. Overhead alone would then place an upper limit on throughput of 5 to 7 times the sequential processing rate, even if the housekeeping were done in a separate processor. At any point in time, it is difficult to foresee how the previous bottlenecks in a sequential computer will be effectively overcome. Let's unpack his statement. The formula itself actually does little justice to show how scary the consequences of the Amdahl's law really are. So let's plot this on a graph. On x-axis, we will have a number of workers that we can throw at the problem. On y-axis, we will plot the number of times we get to go faster if we throw that many workers at a problem. What we're plotting here are different lines corresponding to how much parallelism your overall task has. So the green line, for example, at the very top corresponds to your algorithm or overall task having a whopping 95 parallelism rate. The blue line at the very bottom corresponds to a more modest, just 50% of the overall task is parallelizable. What you can see then is an amazing effect. Basically, even if you have an algorithm that can be 95% parallelizable, which means it can be executed in 95% of its entirety in a perfect parallel fashion, then you only get a speed up of 20, no matter how workers you throw at the problem. 20 becomes your asymptotic limit of a speed up. Always remember this when thinking about theoretical limits of various data parallel processing frameworks, Hadoop or not.